This woman was scammed by her boyfriend. Yes, you heard that right. Her boyfriend scammed and took not 1, 5 or 10, but 100 million and then escaped.
Narakoraga nkamwereza guribi bitewe n'icyo dushaka kugeraho.
Ugereranyije.
Yego.
Ni nk'amafaranga angana iki wabaramuhaye?
Amafaranga ni nka miliyoni ijana.
We all love a story from rags to riches, from zero to hero. But how many times have you heard somebody going from millions to empty pockets? Well, that's what happened to Constance, whose money was taken by the man she loved. But how did she cope with such a loss? Will she ever believe in love again? This is the story of love and betrayal.
My name is Constance, and I used to live in South Africa, where I owned a thriving business. For 3 years, I was in love with a man who was also my business partner.
Constance resided in South Africa, while her boyfriend lived in Rwanda. They were in a long-distance relationship with plans to eventually get married. Frequently, Constance would send money to her boyfriend with the expectation that he would use it to invest in properties like land or houses, preparing for their future together. However, unknown to Constance, her boyfriend appeared to have alternative intentions for the money she had been providing him.
I sent him a large amount of money, and he pretended that he was actually investing in properties, as we had discussed. When the time came for me to return home to my country, I was looking forward to our wedding. We visited both of our families, but whenever I asked him about his progress and what he had accomplished with the money, he resisted showing me. Since I trusted him, I was so naive and didn't worry too much at the time. However, 1 month before our planned wedding, he started acting strangely.
Constance was confused when her boyfriend suddenly stopped coming to visit her. She initially thought the reason might be because she lived in a remote village quite far away. However, the situation became even stranger when the man also completely stopped all communication with her. No phone calls, no text messages. This was very strange behavior from someone she was supposed to marry in just a few days.
He then texted me on Facebook saying he was imprisoned. I looked into it deeply and realized it was just a hoax. He was never actually taken to prison. It made no sense to me. All I could do was inform our families that my partner had disappeared, though it wasn't clear. After around 2 months, the man texted me again and said he was in Ivory Coast. I couldn't believe what was going on, and I just responded, "Okay."
Constance felt utterly disappointed by her partner's actions, as he had completely ruined all the plans she had made, which was the very reason she returned to her home country. However, with time, she has moved forward and is no longer dwelling on the past. Today, Constance is single and actively searching for a new partner who will help her forget the traumatic experience she went through and find happiness once again.
It's been extremely difficult to bear, but I will never give up. I'm still working hard and striving to be self-reliant. I had known him for a very long time, even before we fell in love, and in our culture, I felt marrying someone familiar would be ideal, but that dream never became a reality. He used to show me pictures of cows, farms, houses, and fancy cars just to deceive me into sending him more money. But that will never stop me from continuing to work hard and achieve my goals.
After finishing high school, Constance went to South Africa to visit some relatives. They introduced her to a business opportunity that eventually made her millions. With financial security achieved, Constance's next goal was to start a family. However, her plans for a family life failed in a devastating way.
The amount he took from me was precisely 100 million francs that I had accumulated over 5 years of hard work. I was regularly sending money to this man who I thought would be my future partner, but he played with my heart and stole all of my money. When he told me he was away in a distant country, I had to completely cut ties with him. I think he ran away because eventually I would have discovered the truth and he feared legal consequences. I've learned to let go, and even if he returned asking for forgiveness to restart our relationship, I would never give him a second chance. As they say, fool me once is a mistake, but fool me twice is my own problem.
The events that unfolded left Constance deeply impacted, both physically and emotionally. She is not the same person she once was. At present, she does not envision herself returning to South Africa, as she now believes that with sufficient capital and sound business management skills, one can work and achieve success anywhere in the world.
That man truly hurt me deeply. All my plans were completely ruined, and I have to start over from scratch, which has taken a psychological toll on me. 5 years of hard work and dedication were wasted. I had managed to save some money, and that's what I've had to rely on to begin rebuilding my life again.
Despite the profound disappointment she faced, Constance has not completely ruled out the idea of getting married one day. She still believes there are genuinely serious people out there who are ready to commit to building a family. With this hope in mind, Constance remains open to welcoming any serious candidate who is prepared to take on the responsibilities of marriage and family life.
The most important thing I will consider is someone who genuinely loves and cares for me beyond just financial interests. I don't solely focus on money because it can come and go. With the right mindset and the right partner, people can achieve much more together. I'm not in a rush. I will wait for the right timing from God. And when that time comes, I hope to meet someone who will make me feel like a queen.
As Constance's story shows us, in this ever-changing world, filled with shifting loyalties and broken promises, it is crucial that we all, men and women alike, strive to remain faithful to our values and focus on leaving a positive legacy behind. Her experience of betrayal at the hands of someone she loved serves as a harsh reminder that trust can be shattered in an instant. However, Constance's resilience in the face of such a devastating blow is an inspiration. Her story teaches us that no matter the challenges life throws our way, we must find the strength within ourselves to persevere and forge ahead towards a brighter future. The path will not be easy, and there will be times when the weight of our burdens threatens to overwhelm us entirely. Yet, if we can embrace hope and have faith in our own abilities to overcome, there is always an opportunity to rise above our circumstances and craft the life we deserve. Thank you for watching. I am Simon Greenwood, and this is Afrimax English. Please remember to subscribe.